Okay, so today I'm going to tell you guys how I got this car street tuned and just the entire process behind it, because a lot of stuff went down. It was some good, some bad. So I figured, you know what? Why not tell you the story since I didn't film it? I'm going to try to keep this as short as possible, but if I drag it out, you got to forgive me, because this is just a lot of stuff that happened. So this is like back in August or September. I can't remember the exact month, but my car was literally sitting right over there, just in the street. The engine wouldn't start, or actually the engine did start, and it ran, and it drove fine, but it was running max rich before I had a wideband. So I bought a wideband, and then once I installed the wideband and everything, it was running max lean. And every time I would blip the throttle, it would, you know, go back to around 10 or 11, and I was just confused. I didn't know what I did wrong. So one day, my friend Dedrick hit me up and basically, you know, started sending me base maps. So he's like, okay, here's a base map that you get the car running okay, so you can, you know, drive the car. And I was like, oh, sure, thanks, appreciate it. So he sends me these base maps, and pretty much none of them work. He even went as far as adding, I think, 160% extra fuel than the engine actually needed, which made no sense, because you should never need that much fuel for, you know, like a stock engine setup. So I knew something was up. I knew something just wasn't right, because every time he did that, every time he changed it, it was still running the same numbers, like 16 or 17 for the air-fuel ratio. Eventually, he's like, you know what, maybe I should just come out and kind of just see what I can do and see what's wrong with it. So I was like, yeah, sure, that'd be great, because I haven't been to work in like a month. I was working occasionally using my mom's car, but, you know, driving around a Jeep, doing deliveries when it gets like 14 miles to the gallon isn't the best thing. And I was losing a lot of money just filling the car right back up. He came out, that's when everything kind of started going a little better, because when everything I was doing was just going wrong. The first thing we do is, I think, mess with the timing, because my distributor, I just, you know, I thought you just slap it on and that's it. You don't gotta worry about anything. Apparently, you know, you gotta turn it to the left or right depending on your timing setup and how you want the car to run right. So we adjusted it a little bit. He brought in his timing light, like I said, and we shined it on the crank pulley, and he told me, you know, the lines had to match up, and that's how you know it's spot on. So we did that, it was spot on, and then I believe we went and we tightened all the motor mounts, and just we tightened everything because some of the stuff was loose. Afterwards, then he went in the car in the passenger seat right here, and then he hooked up his computer to my Hendata, and basically he just started typing everything in, and then all of a sudden he asked me, you know, did you upload the base map that I sent you? And I was like, yeah, I uploaded every single one you sent me. And he's like, because it's not showing here. So he tells me to start the car, and I start it, and then he adds the base map that he made, and then the car goes from max lean to about 14.7 in an instant. And I'm just like, bro, you're a god. Like, you saved my car. And I thought that was going to be the end of the day. You know, we just get the car running right. I just drive it around for a little bit and then go get a dyno tune. But he insisted that we were going to do a street tune. So we started out doing partial throttle pulls and then worked our way up to wide open throttle. So like about 20 minutes into the session, we changed the oil. And I wanted to change the oil filter too, but the oil filter at the time was hitting against the intake manifold bracket in the back. And so I had to take that out and change the oil filter at a later time. I didn't actually change it right when I should have. But we changed the oil, no metal shavings, no nothing. And everything was good. So we went back on the road, on the highway, did street, we did partial pulls and everything was fine. I was cracking VTEC for the first time, and it was just so loud. I didn't think it was going to be that loud. And it was just great. It was a really interesting experience. And then, you know, like I said, we changed the oil, and then we came back, and then we went back out to do, you know, wide open throttle, you know, full all-out pulls. And I wasn't ready for this. My car wasn't ready for this. Everything was just changing a little bit. So what I mean by that is, like, the car, I don't think the car was ready for a street tune at that time, because just a lot of stuff was going wrong. We go on the highway. I do a U-turn because there's a lot of traffic going one way and the highway is about to end. So I do a U-turn, and then he just basically tells me, all right, you can go ahead whenever you're ready. So I just floor it. And then all of a sudden the car revs all the way out to about 8. And then I notice, you know, the car kind of stayed in the higher RPMs. And my foot wasn't even on the throttle. And I'm just like, okay, something's not right here. I'm on the throttle right now. Or I'm off the throttle right now. And the clutch is in. And the car is in neutral. But the RPMs is way up. So I got nervous. Clicked on my hazards. Went off to the side of the road. And we got out the car. And actually, once I did this, my rotors were warped. So that the whole entire car was just shaking like crazy. And I was just like, oh my god, everything's going wrong right now. I thought the engine was done. I thought something went wrong. I just thought that was the end. That was the most fun I was ever going to have out of this engine. So we pull off to the side of the road. We get out the car, or we let all the cars pass, open up the hood, and we shine a flashlight in there, and there's just oil everywhere. Oil is just over everything. At the time, I thought, okay, I blew something. So I was just kind of panicking. And he's looking around, you know, he's not seeing anything too serious. So he just kind of says to me, you know, I think everything is all right. I think you're going to be okay. I think we can keep going, basically is what he said. I think we can keep going. And I was like, are you sure about that? Like, there's oil everywhere. My engine was revving way high. And he's like, yeah. He's like, if you don't want to keep going, we don't have to keep going. But if you want to keep going, you know, we can. And I just thought to myself, like, do I really want to risk this right now? Do I really want to risk this? So basically I said, all right, let's keep going. So I realized that there was something on my throttle cable, or my, like, near my throttle body. I think it was the oil catch can line was tucked underneath it, so I got stuck. So ever since then, I had to tuck the oil catch can line under the fuel rail, as you see right now. And that kind of prevents it from getting in the way. So we did that, and all of the oil spewing out everywhere was actually that same exact distributor cam cap bolt that you saw in a couple of videos ago, that I had to kind of put silicone all around because I need to get it helicoiled. Apparently I can't just pick up a cam cap anywhere. I have to get it, you know, machined to that specific head. I didn't know that either. So I'm just gonna get it helicoiled. You know, and when the time is right, and, you know, I shouldn't have any more leak issues. Also, I need a new valve cover because it has a chip in it. So, that was basically the reason why my car is spewing out all that oil. A lot of stuff was loose when I first started running this car. Pretty much everything that you could think of was loose. The battery terminals, the battery wires to the fuse box, the motor mounts. Let's see, what else? The alternator recently happened. The alternator recently went loose and made my battery light flicker all the time when I was doing deliveries a couple days ago. A lot of stuff was loose, and I realize now that, you know, it's really important that I kind of torque everything down. I've kind of been getting roasted a little bit in my group chat because I've been doing a lot of sketchy stuff recently, and I need to take this stuff a little more seriously because, you know, one thing could go wrong and then everything is just done. But anyways, back to the story. He tells me, you know, everything is fine. We should just keep going. So I listen to him. I don't call it quits for now because we're already out there and we got to go back anyway. So, I mean, why not keep going? So we keep going and he's just like, yeah, this car sounds really good. We still got a lot of room left for tuning or whatever. And he was just kept asking me, you know, does it feel good? How does the car feel? And I'm just like, it feels great. This car feels awesome. It feels way different than before. And, you know, I couldn't thank him enough for coming out and helping me, because if it wasn't for Dedrick, you know, this car probably would still be sitting, or it would probably, you know, just have a dyno tune, but that would cost me a lot of money and I'd probably be hurting a little bit, and I probably would have never got the roll bar. So we do wide open throttle pulls, and he's telling me, you know, I'm not going high enough. I'm not maxing out the red line all the way to 8, because my check engine light comes on as like a shift light to let me know, you know, when to shift. And my check engine light was never coming on, so he had to tell me, you know, you need to go a little higher. And I'm like, oh, I thought I was doing it, you know, about right, but no. So I think I was wasting time there, but his battery's dying, so we didn't get a chance to add the two-step or anything, which is not really important at the moment because I don't really need two-step, but that was pretty much everything. The day went smooth after that. We did end up getting lost later on, though, because as I was doing pulls, I had to take a exit so we didn't get too far down the road on the highway. So I took a U-turn, or I took an exit and then made a U-turn and then took the exit back down to the highway, but apparently it was the wrong highway that I got onto. So we started going down south to southern Maryland, and then I got lost at one point, and I had to ask him, could he use his GPS so we could get back? And we end up, you know, going all the way back to my area, and then that pretty much ends the story there. So it was definitely an interesting experience. A lot of stuff went wrong, a lot of stuff went right. I was leaking a lot of oil at the time, too. I think I was losing about a half quart of oil every, like, day. So I had to tighten down everything on the oil pan again and a bunch of other stuff just to get the car running, you know, A-okay. But now it's fine. It still leaks a little bit between the block. It's probably, you know, that bolt, the cam cap in the back. But that was basically the story of how I got my car street tuned. And I'm going to be getting it dyno tuned really soon. Actually, not dyno tuned. I just want to get like kind of like a baseline run just to see where we're at right now, because in the future, you know, stuff's going to change and I'm going to mod stuff in the future. So I kind of want to see where I started at the beginning and then see how much gain I get afterwards. So that's the video. Sorry, no work on the car today. I'm still waiting for parts. I have something special for you guys next week, and I will catch you in the next one.